This video is sponsored by the brand new JV Jiu-Jitsu online store at jvjiujitsu.bigcartel.com. What's going on, everybody? This is Javi Vasquez. I was very blessed to have learned the art of wrestling prior to my jiu-jitsu or MMA training. Wrestling teaches so many valuable skills, including the ability to be able to control where a fight takes place. In this video, I will discuss one of the most basic concepts in wrestling, which is the way I like to pick up a single leg. There are a variety of setups as well as ways to pick up a single leg. There are high, medium, and low single legs. In this video, we will be discussing a mid to high single leg. Once the leg is up, you must be able to maintain your position so that you can keep control of the opponent's leg while it's up in the air. In this video, I will be using an underhook with my head positioned on the side of the opponent's neck and wrist control on the far side wrist as my setup. As always, I hope you enjoy this content and thank you for watching.
Let's break down the single leg that we're working to. Why am I fighting so hard to get to that spot? Because it allows me a place where I can actually get to his leg easier. So sometimes you can do this without dropping your knee. Other times you have to drop to your knee. Even more times you will have to drop to your knee and you will have to pivot out of the way. So there's three levels of resistance: low, medium, and high. Low resistance, I don't even have to drop to my knee. Medium resistance, I do have to drop to my knee. High resistance, I have to drop to my knee and I have to pivot. It's called a sweep center. So I've achieved my underhook and I've placed my head on his neck and my other hand here has his wrist. Now there is a scenario where the leg is easily accessible, and then there is a scenario where the leg is more difficult to reach because it's further back. Okay? We're going to deal with easy, low-hanging fruit. The guy isn't giving us a whole lot of resistance, and his leg is forward. Just to start off, and then as the resistance increases, I have the right tools for the job. So the leg is easily accessible. I have my underhook. If I drop and he drops with me, it's going to be difficult for me to get to that leg. So if he is connected to me here and I drop and I cannot stay with him, I cannot achieve separation or disconnection. My goal is to disconnect. His goal is to maintain that connection. So even though I'm here, his head, if I drop and he drops with me, I can't get to his leg. Does that make sense? If I drop for a moment, fair enough? If I disconnect, I'm in. Now, that's exactly what I want to do. I have his wrist, I have his hand. So when I want to disconnect, I want to drop and leave him up there while I drop down here. Now, when I do that, my hand also turns and drops. I'll get into that a little bit more in a second. So what I want to do is I want to drop and take a step forward. Boom. Now both my hands are on his leg, and the way I'm able to pick the leg up is by pushing into him and making him pop. Okay. Now there are levels to this game. There are multiple problems along the way which we need to solve. Now one thing that we need to understand is what this hand is doing. This is called an overhook or a wizard. If I drop with my fingers pointed up, he's able to hold me up. You guys see that? He holds me up. If I turn his my hand down first. Hold it. Can't hold it. Now there's a reason for that. When I turn my hand down, hold me strong. One hand. Watch what happens to my shoulder here. My shoulder kind of goes forward. My shoulder now will attack his hand. So I'm not pushing down here, where he's strong, right? So if I'm up here, I'm attacking high up here. Can't turn my shoulder down when my hand is up. I am attacking closer towards the wrist, which makes his arm straight. Right? So when I did this underhook here and I turn this hand down, look what happened. He can't hold me up. Now my hand's locked, and now I make him hop. Now how am I locking my hands? And I have a bad habit of locking wrong and picking it up and making the switch. So ultimately I get the job done right, but if you get the job done right from the beginning, even better. So when I drop, I'm trying to separate myself away from his head. My hand turning down will make it difficult for him to hold that up. So I've beaten him in two different steps away. Now the hand that goes around the leg, I want to grab my own wrist. I want the hand that goes around the leg to do all of the work. Because if I use my front hand to grab the wrist and I pick the leg up, he will use his other hand to peel my hands apart. He's gonna pull that up and kick the leg down so my hands go apart. But if this hand grabs and he grabs my hand again, now pull up, he's actually pulling up his own leg. So I want the hand that goes around the leg to grab the wrist. So now, we know that the hand has to turn down. We know that the shoulder has to attack the hand, and we also know that the hand that goes around the leg does all the work. I also know that if I push into him, it makes it easier to pick up his leg. So if I push into him, whether it's with my hand, whatever, if I push into him, I can lift his leg easily. Am I trying to pick up his leg? What am I trying to do? I'm trying to push into him. That's what gets the leg up, pushing into him. Stop trying to pick up people's legs. You can hold the leg and then push into him to pick it up. So let's say, for example, I'm here and Nick makes his leg heavy and I grab a hold of his leg, right? And I'm trying to pick it up. If I try to pick it up this way, it's hard. But if I push into it, it's easy. So you're always looking to push into the guy to pick up the leg. So I have to drop. So my hand turns down and I slide by attacking the shoulder against the hand, and now we. But sometimes, no matter what you do, he's pretty tight. Now, the other thing I want to mention is my hand is not super deep. The deeper this is, the tighter this gets. I want to keep my elbow tight to my own body, and I want to dig my underhook very shallow. The more shallow it is, the less torque he's actually got. Because if he's able to scoop my elbow so that his arm is wrapping above my elbow, crank it, I can't pull it out. I'm pulling against, my elbow runs into his own forearm, into his forearm. But if I don't allow him to scoop at my elbow and he starts to crank here, I can pull my hand out if I need to. So it's important that when you're digging under, that you do not allow the scoop. If the elbow scoops, I have to stop it and then reset my elbow. So my elbow, you feel, it's very shallow. It doesn't have a lot of torque. It is a position to have this. Sometimes, however, no matter what you do, he falls. He doesn't let you get to that level. So what I have to do is I have to bump and then create vibration in order to drop, in order to get to the leg. I need to drop first. Every time I tell you guys to take a shot, I go down, drop, step. You go down, drop, step. I always say down first. I don't say forward. I say down. So you have fought to get yourself to here. What do you think I'm going to take? down. Now there's multiple levels of down, like I mentioned before. There's down and then getting to the leg. Sometimes he follows me and I need to drop to my and then push off and stand up. If he follows me even more, I might need to go down and go around and then pick it up. I might need to take the weight off of me and create an angle to pick it up. That's why I said there's levels of defense that he's got and there's levels of offense that I have. Right now we're working level one. I'm not even dropping to my knee. I'm bending my leg. I'm creating separation between my head and his neck. Leg that goes around the leg, goes all the way. My head can either be here or here. I can push it with my shoulder or my head. Once the leg is up, we have to control the leg. There are two types of control once the leg is up. There's your hands, and then there's the lower control that I have with my legs. Are you guys okay so far, or am I throwing too much? So far, so good? I'm gonna add one last layer to the detail. When I pick up a guy's leg and he starts to defend here, there are three positions where his leg can be. Down the middle, on the outside, and on the inside. When the leg is down the middle, it becomes more neutral. I can work and finish from there, he can work and counter from there. It's kind of a neutral position. So when I drop to here and the leg is down the middle, it's kind of like a neutral position. If he swings his leg to the outside here, he gains an advantage. It's heavier for me to control the leg, and it's harder for me to finish from there. I can finish from there, but it's tough. If I can get his leg to the front, I'm probably going to finish. Can he counter? Yes, he can pull his leg out, he can do a front roll. He can counter. But more often than not, if I get to here and here, I'm going to finish. Whether to the front or whether to the back. So where do I want his leg as an attacker?
Inside or
on the front. What do I want to prevent him from going to? To the outside. So you already know that there's a place where he wants to be and I don't want to be there. So I'm going to fight that battle. So my battle is to either keep him here or to go behind and scoop. So the way I'm going to be able to do that is by shifting my angle. So right now, his leg, go ahead and move your leg around, he's happy. This one, he can go here, he can go in the front, or he can keep it down the middle by poking my leg. But if I turn my body to where now our feet are pointing in the same direction, I get, you feel what's happening there? Here it's a little bit, even if I'm pulling tight to my leg, he can swing his leg in and out. I can kind of pinch. If I pinch this way here, he can still kind of pull. Yes. But when I start to do this, do the same thing. Go around your leg. It's tougher. And if he beats me on the outside, I step over it again. I am fighting to maintain this position. Now sometimes what he'll do is he'll pull his foot out. Boop, now I can start to scoop him. There's two ways that I can get this leg up on the front. The first way is to step my knee behind, elevate, and scoop. It's an easier way. The more challenging opponent is hooking that leg, not allowing, he's very sticky, not allowing that to happen. If that is the case, I'm going to grab his heel and physically move the leg out of the way. And I help myself up and change to another. Now I can dig it under, and now I'm going to push. So if you notice, there are multiple problems along the way. Depending on the level of defense, I have to make multiple adjustments or use multiple tools. Let's go with the level one opponent. Level one opponent, we can drop without having to drop to our knees and pick up the leg. level one opponent, we can scoop behind the leg, elevate, underhook the arm, and now we're going to take it down. So that's what I want. I want you to be able to pick up the leg and then pick it up high. So I have my underhook. You already know getting to this position is going to be a battle. Now we have the drop. My head has to change level. My hand turns down, and I'm... Now that the leg is here, we're going to go level one opponent. My leg is able to come around his knee, hold, transfer, and underhook the arm. You get to here, we'll set through again. You do two, your partner does two. So he's going to get the underhook in position, boom, he's going to get the underhook. Going to control the wrist, he's going to change. Remember, I'm leaning into him. There's tension in the rope here. He's going to drop down below me. Boom, there it is. Push into me to pick up the leg. From here, he's going to go level one opponent. He's going to go behind. He's going to help himself up and underhook and then establish. Underhook the leg deeper. Nope. Deeper at your elbow. Yes. You want to scoop at the elbow. If you're doing this, I'm going to pull this out. See, it kind of creates like, it's like in a little valley. It makes it more difficult to get my leg out. And then we'll work on the finish. Level one opponent. Change your level. Create separation. Create an elevational change with your head and then push into him to pick up the leg. The leg that goes around the arm that goes around the leg does all the work. It goes around the leg and it grabs your wrist. Once the leg is up, you're going to shift your angle to where your toes are all pointing in the same direction. And then you're able to unlace the toes, elevate, change, and then
hey everybody, thank you so much for watching my video. Please click like and subscribe to my channel for more great strike-based jiu-jitsu content. If you have any questions about the techniques that I'm demonstrating, please leave a comment in the comment section below. Thank you so much.